Semuanya sejuan. Putih bener.
Kece ya.
Ya, hidangan kita salju satu meja. Silakan duduk di atas salju. At gue udah di sini di Big Bear. Ada si Itap. Mas bro kita nih. Ini orang bisa dibilang harus diacungin jempol karena masih muda tapi udah sukses. Mau tahu kesuksesannya apa? Hah, suksesnya apa? Timnya dia CLS Championship dan menang. Ya, ya bro ya. Baru tahun ini kan? Oh iya iya iya. Iya, yeah, that's what I meant. Pokoknya timnya dia CLS Knights dan menang tahun ini. Dan sekarang lu ngapain bro? Yang women basketball team itu?
Oh, timnas putri.
Timnas putri, bayangin. Gara-gara apa sih kok bisa deeply involved ke basket begini?
Gara-garanya mungkin gara-gara Tuhan ya. Karena buat gue basket tuh lebih dari cuma olahraga, karena itu salah satu jalannya Tuhan untuk tetap jaga gue supaya gue tetap masih hidup sampai sekarang.
Jadi
karena
sehat ya.
Itu salah satu ya salah satu cara Tuhan lah bikin gue lepas dari segala yang nggak baik.
Oke, okay, good. Lalunya. Ya jadi untuk menghindari yang lain-lain, menghilangkan stres juga mungkin ya. Eh bro. Terus kalau yang putri itu gimana ceritanya nih? Yang barusan SEA Games ya?
Kemarin SEA Games memang ya kita tetap masih bisa dapat medali, masih bisa pertahanin medali. Cuman memang agak berat yang kemarin ini karena lawan-lawan ada beberapa tim yang pakai pemain asing.
Oh wow, tinggi-tinggi bukan, gitu ya?
Ya secara skill juga beda. Tapi selain itu ya memang itu bukan jadi satu alasan yang utama. Kita mau tetap coba lagi ke depannya. Semoga kita juga bisa naturalisasi pemain. Dengan begitu kita juga bisa bersaing di level bukan cuma SEA Games saja tapi level yang lain juga.
Awesome, man.
Ningkatin FIBA rankingnya Indonesia lah gitu.
Awesome, awesome. Bro,
ya.
Jadi kesibukan lu selain ngurusin basket tuh apa aja bro?
Ngurusin keluarga, ya, ngurusin itu. Anak,
terus
ya, perusahaan.
Ya, tau micin? Ya, ya keluarga apa? Generasi micin. Ya itu dia, itu tuh yang punya Sasa. Ya. Jadi kalau ketemu dia jangan bilang Ajinomoto.
Oh, enggak, okay.
Apa-apa,
sama aja.
Oh, sama aja. Sama-sama bikin bego. Bro.
Wah, apa nih?
Lu kalau punya banyak uang, ya. Hmm. Banyak banget. Hmm. Okay, let's say if you win a lottery. Sekarang dia sih mungkin enggak perlu ya, tapi let's say 1T. Hmm. Lu pakai duit itu buat apa? Itu duit gampang ya.
Gampang. Bangun usaha dulu.
Oke.
Lalu bikin sesuatu sosial yang bisa membantu orang.
Non-profit organization ya, mungkin ya.
Lalu bikin sekolah.
Sekolah is very good actually. Because you can help sekarang for the future, yeah.
Yeah,
right.
Younger generation.
There you go. Terus yang lo mau didik tuh apa? Bukannya katanya di Indo tuh udah mau dihapus ya nih dan lain-lain.
Ya nggak tahu itu. Pak Menteri kita yang baru pasti punya agenda bagus ya.
Gitu ya.
Ya yang mau di yang pasti yang harus kita tanemin itu values ke anak-anak karena tanpa values, mau sepinter apapun, mau sekaya apapun, kita semua orang bisa jatuh. Jadi tanpa values ya sia-sia lah.
There you go. Very wise. Terus sekarang nih, kalau if you have the power, what will you do to make Indonesia a better place?
Sekarang ini mungkin secara dengan skala yang kecil yang gue bisa lakuin, gue udah coba ngelakuin di bidang olahraga untuk bawa Indonesia jadi ke tingkat yang lebih tinggi lagi di olahraga basket. Itu yang skala kecil yang gue bisa lakuin saat ini. Cuma ya gue sendiri punya keterbatasan, tapi gue yakin satu saat Indonesia juga di sisi yang sekarang gue lakuin ini, di sisi olahraga, gue yakin akan banyak orang-orang baru yang akan ngelakuin hal-hal besar dan ngebawa Indonesia di kancah dunia lah.
Sedap.
Ya gue harap apa yang gue udah lakuin selama ini bisa jadi motivasi, bisa jadi inspiring buat orang-orang.
Bukan
cuma atlet.
It's already is, man.
Bukan cuma atlet. Mungkin orang yang punya uang, orang yang hobi olahraga. Karena gue tahu banyak banget orang Indonesia yang hobi basket. Kemarin gue ke Staples Center tuh banyak banget orang Indonesia di sana. Tapi
yang kerja nih?
Enggak.
Yang datang ya?
Yang nonton. Okay. Tapi kan untuk banyak yang suka nonton, tapi sedikit yang mau ngebangun. Ya gue harap apa yang gue udah lakuin ini bisa jadi inspiring lebih banyak lagi orang-orang yang mau invest untuk olahraga di Indonesia.
Nice. Lu kan lebih di olahraga ya. Kenapa fokusnya lebih ke olahraga, bro?
Karena sebentar lagi semua pekerjaan kita itu diganti sama mesin. Hampir semua pekerjaan di dunia itu bisa diganti sama mesin. Hanya ya kira-kira dua pekerjaan yang sulit untuk tergantikan sama mesin, kreativitas sama sports. Lu mau taruh robot main basket, main sepak bola, gak bakal bisa.
Who would win? Batman or Superman?
Batman.
Kenapa?
Mind over muscle.
Tapi kan Superman bisa dibilang tak terkalahkan, bro.
Superman kuat, nggak ada yang bisa, nggak ada ya.
Then how do they beat? Batman beat?
Di komik nggak ada manusia yang bisa ngalahin Superman, tapi Batman selalu punya strategi dan dia udah tahu kelemahannya Superman, Kryptonite. Jadi dia bisa taruh Kryptonite mungkin di mana aja, mungkin ada di dalam celana dalam dia, kita nggak pernah tahu ada Kryptonite-nya.
Okay.
Dan pada saat Superman dekat sama dia lemas.
Kalau banyak pecinta basket nih, ya the basketballers Indo ya gitu ya, yang nanyain nih, what is going to happen with CLS? Sekarang udah menang, terus mau kemana? Serius, ada yang nanya loh.
Ya memang. Setelah keputusan gue terakhir untuk gak manage CLS lagi, ya memang banyak yang kecewa, banyak yang terharu. Ya gue minta maaf kalau sampai kecewa, tapi ya ini memang udah decision pribadi gue. Tapi jangan khawatir, CLS gak kemana-mana, CLS tetap ada. Dan mungkin sebentar lagi akan ada beritanya. Ada manajemen baru yang akan ngurusin CLS.
Really?
Mereka juga bukan sembarangan. Mereka juga di level, mungkin belum di level profesional, tapi di level amatir. Udah beberapa kompetisi mereka juga nunjukin mereka bisa juara. Dan mereka akan main di kompetisi luar negeri juga. Jadi,
are you going still to be involved in the team?
Ya mungkin gue mendukung di ini aja lah, secara doa
Karena itu juga udah part of your family istilahnya ya, bro
buat
ya.
Gue tetap challenge tuh keluarga, jadi gue nggak mungkin apa maksudnya nggak mungkin gue ya udah pergi gitu aja ninggalin jelas nggak, cuman ya gue nggak di sisi manajemennya aja intinya itu.
Nice, oke. Okay. Gue kan pernah datang juga tuh ke Chalice waktu itu ya, yeah. Tahun lalu, is it tahun lalu atau tahun ini ya?
Tahun lalu
ya. Bro, itu gokil bro. Orang tuh bisa teriak-teriak, bisa yang apa pendukungnya ya, itu super heboh. Itu gara-gara apa bisa begitu bro? Benar-benar hearted banget mendukungnya, full hearted.
Mungkin
kok ya, bisa gitu ya?
Karena cinta.
Oh ya?
Karena cinta, mereka. Mereka ngerasa itu mereka bukan lagi cuman spectator, orang datang nonton, tapi mereka itu benar-benar fanatik yang buat mereka ini keluarga, ini milik mereka sendiri, yang mereka nggak akan terima kalau sampai miliknya tuh kalah gitu.
Betul betul.
Itu yang terjadi.
That's the word, fanatik ya.
Iya.
Terus. kalian mungkin bisa lihat di YouTube, pasti udah ada juga beberapa videonya gitu ya. Ada apa panci ya bro ya?
Oh, tutup panci.
Tutup panci. Itu super heboh ya. Itu idenya mereka sendiri atau?
Jadi awalnya tuh ada satu orang yang bawa tutup panci. Lalu itu jadi nyebar.
Oh, ya?
Jadi tradisi. Itu kejadian di Amerika juga pernah kejadian di Sacramento Kings mungkin.
Pakai panci
tuh,
juga?
Enggak, pakai lonceng sapi.
Oke. Okay.
Pakai lonceng sapi. Di makanya di depan gornya tuh ada satu kayak statue lonceng sapi gede. Gitu.
Wow.
Mungkin satu saat di depan gor Chalice ada tutup panci gede.
Ya, ini antusias banget ya, kalau orang benar-benar cinta tuh senyumnya beda tuh, lihat gitu, senyumnya beda bro, kita masuk bro dingin kayak ketombe lu udah mulai banyak tuh.
3, 2, 1
ketemu lagi. Ini teman basket mana bro?
Kita makan bukan teman basket.
Enggak, intinya gue datang sini untuk
nungguin makan.
Gue tunggu lapar dulu
nih, cuman sambil nunggu lu nunggu makan, gue mau main basket nih. Gue kenalin lu sama satu orang ini. Nah,
wih deh,
ini idola para janda.
Au. Wei Long. Ini teman-temannya nih. Ya, kebanyakan licin-licin, palanya licin-licin. Licin lagi. 3. Basket perutnya gendut.
Sakit.
Iron Man. That's way long. I'm stealing weight.
Hey.
Yo. Come here.
What's up?
Let's go.
Where?
Sit down.
Where?
Okay, this is not good. Let's go.
Way long.
What's up?
Hey, your name is cool, yeah?
Not really.
What? It's actually very cool. It's long.
Yeah, it's long. Very long.
Way long.
Very long.
Hey, wait, you're from Singapore, right?
Yeah.
So you were born there?
Yes.
And you're Singaporean? 100%?
Yes.
So no Indonesian blood?
Both my parents are Indonesian.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, both my parents are from Indonesia.
So would you call yourself Indonesian or Singaporean?
Singaporean. Because I've been staying there for the past 31 years.
But okay. And you were born there too, yeah?
Yeah, I was born there.
Singaporean, okay. So you're an import?
Not really an import, but just it just happened that both my parents are Indonesia, are from Indonesia, and I got a chance to play for CLS. So
yeah, when you came for CLS, how did you join CLS? Did CLS find you, or
I think that was back in 2018 September, where I got a chance to play in one of the Malaysia, one of the tournament in Malaysia, and happened that CLS was in the tournament as well, and I'm not really very sure how they know my parents' background as such. So Hendry came. Hendry is one of our team manager.
And who's Hendry?
Hendry is the I think is our CLS team manager.
Okay.
And then he came forward and asked me if I'm keen to play for CLS, and then he understands that both my parents are Indonesian, and that's where he gets started.
And did that time you were in the contract with the?
No, I wasn't. I don't have any contract.
And what team was that?
It was a local team, and
what's the name of
that
it?
That is Adroit Sports Association. And we were playing in this tournament, and I've been playing for them for the past 3-4 years.
Okay, I have one. Somebody asked me about this. CLS Knights or Singapore Stingers?
I had a very, very good experience with CLS Knights, and not to forget, I played for Singapore Stingers for the past 7 years. And I built like great bond with all my teammates, and good bonding with my coaching staff as well. But the most memorable experience that I had would be the CLS Knights, because I won the champion.
That
was back.
Everyone remember that.
Yeah. So I thought that was a great experience for me, for my family, and also for the students that I've been training in Singapore, letting them understand that you could actually go overseas to try and get some
be an inspiring person. Okay, good. Yeah, I have a few more questions. Okay, what is your favorite indoor food? You've been living in indoor though. When you were at CLS.
What was that? The Sahadana.
Sahadana?
Yeah, Sahadana.
What is that? Because I'm not from Surabaya. Is that from Surabaya?
I think so.
Is it?
I think so. So it's kind of like there's like nasi padang.
Nasi padang.
And there's chicken, there's veg, there's lots of like varieties for you to pick.
Yeah.
So I really like that.
So it's like instant food that they already prepared. Or you have to order to cook?
No, they are all cooked food, but was placed on the table. So you can see like 20 plates on the
like
table.
So it's like nasi padang?
Yeah, I think
it's
so.
It's like that?
Yeah.
That's the way they serve it?
Yeah. So that was interesting, and I really liked it.
Name three of them. Three Indonesian favorite of yours.
Food?
Yes.
That is one.
Okay.
Indomie? That's two. No, everybody loved that. The third one will probably be, it's not really Indonesian food. It is. It's like fried chicken.
Geprek? Geprek? Ayam geprek? Is that what it is?
I think so. No, I had like
the one with chili?
I think so. I had like 8 chicken wings, 8 chicken pie at one go. Shirley and Chris brought me there, and it was really nice. And all my friends love it too, when they come to.
I still wonder, I have to ask.
Yeah, somebody. But it was really nice. That was one of my best experiences.
Because I might be going to Surabaya.
Okay.
And probably you're one of my go-to person.
Okay, that's
but
really good.
But it happens that you don't know the name.
No, I don't know.
you know the shadow, but you don't know the name.
Yeah.
You're bad. Okay, bro. What is your favorite go-to move?
Me?
When you play ball.
No, I like to show, because I'm the shortest player in the team, so, and also one of the shortest player in the league. No, I always have the tendency to look away from the basket, and I always caught them off guard, and okay, I'll take a shot. No, without looking at the rim.
So you're the best stealer in the team?
No, not really. Best supporting, maybe best supporting cast.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So
yeah. So your mom and dad, they play basketball or they love basketball so much?
Both my parents are very, very supportive towards me. You know, when I first started, my dad plays basketball back then, and
for pro?
No, just leisurely.
Okay.
And I think he entered to the national youth team once.
Oh,
just before he entered to the national youth team.
Indonesian.
Yeah.
Indonesian.
Yeah, I think so. So just before he entered to the national youth, when he was 17, 18 years old, he left country.
Okay, Jordan or Kobe?
Jordan definitely.
Jordan or LeBron?
Jordan.
Really?
Yeah.
Jordan all the way?
Yeah, Jordan all the way.
Okay, no, Kobe or LeBron?
Kobe or LeBron? Kobe.
You like Lakers?
I love Lakers now.
Yeah. Now?
Yeah, now.
Because of LeBron?
No, because I just watched their game yesterday and I had a
you
good
enjoyed
experience.
It, huh?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I had the best experience ever. So.
Great. Okay, this is a private.
Mm-hmm.
If I have to ask you, and if you can tell me,
mm-hmm.
Do you get paid monthly salary or is it a season contract? How do people pay a basketball player? Or is there different cases where if you're an import, it's a different case?
Not really. So it all depends on your on the experience that you have. If you are a much established player in the league, you probably get slightly more than a rookie player.
You can bargain higher.
Based on the statistics.
More benefits.
Yeah, more benefits.
Okay. Okay, I got two more.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of tree do you want to be if you were born as a tree?
As a tree.
And why?
Probably durian tree.
Durian tree? Why is that?
No one tells.
Because you love durian?
No, I'll have a very peaceful environment to live in because no one there to. Not many people would dare to go go around that area because if durian drop, you probably get. You probably need to go to hospital, so.
Oh, wow.
I like peaceful.
Okay. One last one before we have to leave. If you are an animal, if you were born as an animal, what kind of animal?
Eagle? Yeah.
The bird?
Yeah. Free.
Why?
Free. Get the predator.
All right. Thank you, Waylong. We gotta catch up.
Okay.
Bye.
But don't.
You.
Forget.
Two. Like.
Comment.